still can't believe I spent $150 on dinner and didn't, yeah, even bought flowers. I'm done being the nice guy. No, you're not done being the nice guy. You were never the nice guy. You only did all of that stuff with the intent of, yeah. So, no, you're not a nice guy. Never were. What's going on, Modern Toads? It's your boy, Long Nail, back again with another new video. And in today's video, we're going over the hot posts from r/niceguys. Let's get into it. Who are we? Girls! Whom do we want to date? Loyal boys who cares and loves. Whom do we date? Popular and handsome boys. What do we do with the loyal boys? Friend zone them! I don't think that's how this goes, man. I think chicks in general don't go, huh, this dude's too loyal for me. You know what? I'm gonna friend zone him. Maybe if they weren't interested in the first place, you'll end up in the friend zone, but really you never had a chance. And this is ridiculous, which is most likely the case, because typically nice guys aren't as nice as they pretend to be. And that's often found out immediately after they get rejected, which is so ironic. I'm so sorry for your loss. My condolences to this young woman's family. Grace was a beautiful young woman. Why do women these days dating bad boys? Unfortunately, good Christian guys always fished last. Fished or finished? And clearly you're not as good is you're trying to act, because instead of just saying sorry for your loss and leaving it at that, you have to take a dig at a time like this, because she wasn't into you. So you go, I'm just going to dig a little bit and make this completely unnecessary comment. Since my boyfriend and I are long distance, we've been playing Among Us to stay connected. And this came in the mail from him today. Where do y'all find these men?
Where do you find these kind of guys?
Yet, they right in front of their eyes, and they only be choosing the ones that F them over. But it's I, we not enough. Type guys y'all seem to think are the worst getting successful. They're the nice guys y'all shot down. No, they're not. These are just dudes that have a girlfriend that are doing something cool to further their relationship and show love and appreciation. But you wouldn't understand that. Hey Mandy, I'm sort of similar on what I'm looking for. Depends on the person. You seem like you could keep an interesting conversation going, so that's a good start. I'll refrain from commenting on your chest like all the other clownfish do, I'm sure. At least for now. But you did comment on her chest. Even in your fake attempt to not be like the other guys, you instantly turned yourself into one of the other guys. And then you say, at least for now. Like, dude, that is so awkward. You're never, ever in a million years gonna get the response you want talking like this. So tell me more about yourself. I'm poor. And then she leaves. Of course that's how this meme goes, because, you know, a nice guy posted it. Sure, there are some girls that are only into dudes because of their money. Is it a majority of girls? No, not at all. And maybe you're just picking the wrong girls, and you're just not finding the real nice ones. Oh, you don't like when that's used against you like that? Shocker! Are there any females left that will say thank you when somebody holds the door open for you? Are you one of them? Okay, so I'm assuming this post happened after the dude saw one cute girl, held the door, and she didn't immediately bow down to him. Or heaven forbid, she didn't say thank you because she was distracted or something. Like, he just didn't get the acknowledgement he was looking for, and now he's ranting on Facebook. Like, sure, when I hold the door, I really appreciate a thank you. But am I going to go on a rant about it on Facebook if I don't get one thank you? No, I'm not. wholesome guys that actually love them. And she looks back at the dudes that will break their hearts.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure they will.
When a guy is nice and showers her with compliments. When a guy is insulting and ignores her.
Oh, yeah, I don't know what kind of chicks are into getting insulted and ignored on a daily basis. So maybe take a step back and look at what you're doing and why chicks aren't responding. Because probably the things you're doing are insulting to her.
I just think we want different things, and I don't have any free time to spare for anyone right now. No cold shoulders.
Eh, it's all good. I know I'm a good catch.
Reasonable start. Let's see how it takes a turn. Someone will appreciate directness and my wicked sense of humor someday. Well, you taught me a valuable lesson. Don't tell people my jokes. Kinda bummed. Didn't even get a chance. Total tease.
Yep, that's how you turn it from a reasonable response, showing confidence in yourself and not letting one person get you down, and make it into a really sad, creepy response. Like, oh, you should have just left it after the first message, dude.
Hey, do you know how to be friends with girls? Just say, I love you. She'll say, we're just friends.
Yeah, probably. Especially when you're instant messaging somebody on Facebook that you've never met or have never talked to in real life. Yeah, that is what happens.
How the logic of friend zoning would work if applied in other instances.
Oh, this has got to be golden. Let's see.
Man walks into a store and finds employee.
Man, all right, I've had enough. Why haven't you guys hired me?
Employee. Well, sir, when did you put in your application?
I never filled out an application.
Well, sir, we can't consider you for employment if you've never filled out an application.
No, that's nonsense, because I've been coming here for years now, and every single time I tell you how much I love this store and how much I appreciate your customer service, unlike some of your other customers, I might add.
Well, but that doesn't...
And I even told you that I didn't have a job.
But, sir, that doesn't indicate to us that you would like a job at our store. And again, if you've never filled out an application, we can't consider you. Besides, we're not hiring.
Oh, not hiring. What a laugh. I see your store go through seasonal workers all the time. They come and go like nothing. But you won't consider me as a part-time employee, even though I know you've been looking for workers to fill positions? That's insane.
Sir, we've been looking to hire a few people for management positions. Do you have any management experience?
Well, no, but what does that matter?
Well, sir, that's what we're looking for. You won't be suitable for the position without management experience.
Oh, that's such a load of baloney. You know, you'll be waiting around for a long time for a manager if you don't lower your standards a little. Who cares if someone knows how to manage a store? I love this store, and I'm willing to work here. That's all that should matter to you.
That doesn't make any sense.
No, I'm done. This is over. From now on, no more Mr. Nice Guy.
And then, of course, the man would proceed to cuss out the employee. Or, you know, if we take it in the more literal sense, the girl. Because for some reason, they always feel like they're so entitled to date a chick, even if she's not interested in the slightest. For whatever reason, it doesn't care how much you love her or how much you've always been there for her. Cool, you're a great friend. Awesome, man. If she doesn't feel the same way, so what? Move on and find somebody else. That doesn't mean you have to stop being a great friend or never go back to that store. It just means you're going to have to look elsewhere.
All right, Modderchodes, that's it for the hot post from r/niceguys. If you enjoyed the video, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. And of course, share this video with your friends. Till next time, peace.